two straws. That's bad for the turtles. Trooper. Yo, today is Monday. Yesterday was Sunday. I know you know how that works, the calendar. The shit's been the same for like eons. But I didn't make it out yesterday. Saturday night, you know I played at Harrah's. You know I played 7 hours? Yeah, 7 hours. The only real thing I had to eat, the only thing that wasn't a bowl of cereal, oh, it's gone. I had some healthy cereal. I had that like at night. The only thing I had when I went out and about was that breakfast burrito from Harrah's Food Court. About 8 hours after I had that burrito, when I came home, I had all kinds of sharp pain action going in the abdominal region. And all I know is I woke up Sunday morning in an unusual manner, needing to go to the restroom. Let's not get too graphic, but I was in the restroom, I think a total of 4 or 5 times Sunday. That burrito effed me up. There's no way it could have been anything else. In the morning, when I was editing the vlog, I had these little Pop-Tart joints. Then I had that burrito. Then I came home and had a small bowl of healthy cereal. And then I had a little bit of carrot cake that Gun Girl had made for me. And that's it. There's zero chance it was the carrot cake because I had it for like 3 nights in a row. There's zero chance it was the Pop-Tarts because I have them sometimes all the time. And it was the third one out of a box of 3. And there's zero chance that it was the cereal. So, it had to be the burrito. Yeah, obviously, it wasn't anything serious like E. coli or salmonella or whatever, but it was some kind of foodborne something. Either it was either an expired burrito or it was a tainted burrito. A burrito that had been in the danger zone for too long or something like that. I don't know what happened, but all I know is no more damn breakfast burritos from Harrah's. And it's a pretty good option too, as long as it doesn't ruin an entire day for you. So yeah, basically the point is, I didn't sleep well Saturday night, and I felt sick all day Sunday, and then I did my little stream shit, so there's no vlog that went up today. There was no vlog from Sunday. That also means I didn't get any hours at Harrah's. Now, the Harrah's promotion, I've made an executive decision. The biggest challenge when it comes to playing 60 hours at Harrah's is the game itself. Sitting around with the table being 90% locals who are just doing the same thing is miserable. Shut up. Can't stand it. On Friday and Saturday, the game was much better. And we had a really good game going Saturday until it got pissed all over. But other than that, the game is miserable. Last Monday and Tuesday, the game was the worst game I've ever played in. Ever. The worst. Now, this is nothing against the room. I like the room. I like the atmosphere. I like the location. I like the staff. For the most part, I like Harrah's, but I do not like sitting around with those same people just trying to get hours. It's a miserable game. I hate it. I don't want any part of it. As far as playing the 60 hours, I can play the 60 hours. That's not really a challenge. I only need 15 hours. I could easily play 7 hours today, 8 hours tomorrow, 0 hours on Wednesday, and I'm good with the 60 hours. The problem is, I don't wanna do it. I'm only gonna get 50 hours. I'm gonna play 5 hours today, and that's it. I am not subjecting myself to those last 10 hours. My attitude about those last 10 hours has changed. my attitude in the beginning was, oh, well, those last 10 hours are worth more than all the other 50 hours as individual hours, and that's true, but I'm not gonna do it. I'm not gonna do it. It would be better off that I play my next 10 hours at Caesars or somewhere else, Bellagio, anywhere, especially Bellagio 2-5. So the $500 1-2 at Harrah's, in the past I have said that it's the same game as Bellagio 2-5. Well, it can be the same game. It's not the same game when you have 8 other people who are all just sitting around getting hours for the free roll. So that's it. That's where I stand on the Harrah's promotion. I'm gonna complete my qualifying today. Tomorrow is Tuesday. I'm not going to the strip to play poker tomorrow. I'm gonna go shoot guns with Gun Girl. I haven't had food yet today. I think we know I don't want anything from the Harrah's food court, especially a breakfast burrito. Smashburger is not fantastic, but it's not a breakfast burrito from Harrah's. So when it comes to getting cool intro shots for the vlog, one thing I've learned is that if you're shooting something from a certain spot, if you just move a few steps in any direction, you get a whole different perspective, a whole different angle of the same thing, and it makes the shot completely different. Trooper, what's the point? Nothing to do with the shot, just in an attempt to find shots for the intro today, I found a quarter right on the ground. I can feel about 3 of you out there thinking right now, Trooper, Trooper, 2 straws? That's bad for the turtles. I have a solution for the straw problem. Actually, I have multiple solutions to the straw problem. That's not what you think it is. That's supposed to be a quote, quotation mark. First of all, straws have been around for decades and decades and decades. Plastic straws, mind you. I don't believe that paper straws are the answer. Here's what I'm thinking. First of all, if we can ever get recycling affordable, I understand plastic may be a problem. Maybe it's not. I don't know enough. But why don't they make straws out of that hard plasticky material that they make from vegetable oil? You know, like the cups at Earth Cafe? They're like hard plastic cups like this, but they're made from vegetable oil. And so it's compostable. Here's another idea. Why don't they get small shredders? If you're worried about turtles and not so much the earth itself, why don't they just get shredders that you can put your straw into when you're done with it? They could be right in there in Starbucks, right by the trash cans. Little straw shredders. Here we are, downtown Las Vegas. Shout out to Moosey. Moosey, got your little chapeau from this cat, the Trooper.
There you go. Yeah.
Shout out to somebody else too. No, that's who, that's the only person.
Oh, Moose. Okay, got it.
Shout
got
out
it.
To Daryl.
Daryl. Thanks a lot, Moose.
Yeah.
Got the karaoke action going.
up for a little pee break. About halfway through my 5 hours, I just had a disappointing hand. I raised early position to 12 with aces, and the button, who is a regular, not necessarily a Harris regular, but a regular in general. I think he plays somewhere else other than Harris on a regular basis. But he's been here for the last 2 weeks. He's on the button and he 3-bet to 30. I decided to just call. The flop was queen 8-8 with two diamonds. I checked and he checked behind. The turn was, I believe it may have been the seven of diamonds. It was a diamond. I bet 25 and he called. The river was like meaningless. I don't even remember what it was. Let's just say the five of clubs. I led for 60 and he raised to 150. Well, I don't like it. I had two black aces. And I figure the only hand that he's raising, I do not believe he's raising with air on the river. The worst hand he has is a flush. I kind of feel like he would have led the flop with a flush draw though. Maybe, maybe not. I really think he has queens full. I don't think that he's raising jacks on the river. I think he's raising with a flush minimum, and I think that if he has queens full, he would have played it exactly the way he did. And I think that if he had kings, he may have played it the same way with kings. I think that the only hand that he's raising the river that I have beat is kings. He could have the other two aces. That's a possibility. But I think he has queens full. I folded. I showed him the aces and folded. He didn't show, and he tried to tell me it was a flush. I don't believe it was a flush. I think it's more likely that it was actually queens full. I really think the only hand that he's raising with that I beat is kings. That makes it a good fold, but who knows? So here's the problem with poker. You either have to have the best hand or you have to successfully bluff people off of the best hand. I never ever have the best hand. I just never have the best hand the entire night. I have 50.03 hours and I'm done. Minus 297, not a huge deal or anything, but even with aces, I never have the best hand. You know, like on day two, maybe day two or day three of playing that promotion, I remember giving it a lot of thought and figuring out a pretty decent estimate of what it was worth. And I said it wasn't worth it, and I said, I'm gonna continue because I committed to it. That was the mistake. That was the mistake right there. And hey, I'm not trying to be results oriented. I'm not talking about the fact that the last week and a half or so has been kind of rough and I'm down. I'm talking about the fact that the games suck. I'm talking about the fact that I'm trapped in there because I committed to getting a certain number of hours. That's what I'm talking about. It's just a miserable game. And I'll tell you another thing. The chairs are unbelievably bad. They're all breaking. They're falling apart. Pretty sure you should have seen the back of one of them fell off while I was sitting there. Pretty much every damn night, my back and legs are killing me by the time I leave there. And I adjust the chair multiple times throughout the night to try to make it a little more comfortable. Holy shit. So now, I have one more thing to do at Harris, and that's play the tournament on Thursday at 10 a.m. I know what you're thinking, Trooper. How the hell are you gonna play the tournament? It's gonna be Trooper Thursday. Trooper Thursday is going to start promptly at 2 p.m. I may be a few minutes late. The game will start without me, and I will keep everyone at Trooper Thursday updated by way of Instagram. And as soon as I am out of the tournament, I will be there within 15 minutes. By the way, shout out to Scott from Baltimore who got a bag of coffee from me there at Harris tonight. Okay, I got a shipment of Go Gamble merchandise right here to deliver to someone who ordered online to pick it up here in Vegas. So, let's go find this guy. Say what up to Todd from Fresno.
Yeah. Shout out to Tiffany up in the room and Bowen and Serena staying with Grandma.
There you go. And that will conclude this Monday on the Las Vegas trip for the Trooper anyway. I'm pretty sure Monday will continue for a few more hours. I'm gonna go home, edit my vlog. Tomorrow's Tuesday. Will there be a vlog from Tuesday? I honestly do not know. Maybe I'll throw a video together. We'll see. Gonna go shoot guns. We'll see what happens. You'll remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. I'm gonna see you next time.